I think Rose is hot. What are we doing here? Okay.
Hi, how you doing there, little Tinkerbell? Buzz, 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 buzz.
I got, oh my. I had an acid trip suddenly.
What the hell was that?
Oh, excuse me, I'm just hungry. That was my tummy. No, I was about to say, Alan, before you flashbacked and interrupted me, the remaster looks great. The remaster, it looks very good. It's not the most beautiful remaster I've ever seen. This isn't Blue Point.
Something uncoiled itself inside my head. I realized that I'd have to find a way across. I didn't even want to look at the water.
Wait, what uncoiled inside your head? I'm looking at the water. I'm looking at the water. What is coiling inside your head? Do you have like a tapeworm up there? Do you have some type of parasitic device or a thing inside your head? What uncoiled? Alan, I'm very concerned about something that's uncoiling inside your head. That could be a serious medical condition, and we need to talk about it. Is there anything over here? Oh, coffee! I almost walked right past it. Something uncoiled inside my head. That is probably the best way I could describe how it feels to me when I get deja vu. Now, you see, if he said it was in... I am in the woods, Starlight. I am in the woods. Although it's not Jason Voorhees out here. But there is a bunch of axe-wielding maniacs. But, no, Star...
Stucky was still out there, in the dark, stalking me.
Okay. But what about this place where I can get something special to eat? Where can I get something special to eat? I would like something special to eat. What is that? Is that... Can I go over there? Can I get over there? Is that where I came from? Hold on a second. Can I go back over here? Okay, so that's where I came from. And then there's... Jump, Alan! There you are. Come over here. And... I come this way. Alright, what is this? It's... Oh! Manuscript page! Glad I came this way.
Barry Wheeler was bouncing off the walls. He jumped on a plane after his calls were ignored by both Al and Alice for several days. It could mean that they were both on a second honeymoon. But Barry didn't buy it. Al had been way too unstable for that. Not sleeping. Messed up. Barry had years of experience dealing with Alan Wake. And he couldn't ignore it. Something was wrong.
He knew that they couldn't be on a second honeymoon after all of Alan Wake's medical problems in the bedroom. That he told Barry in private. But Barry told everybody. Everybody knew. Oh, little baby trees! I'm easily distracted. I don't think I've ever heard of this game. Oh my goodness, Starlight, what? Starlight, you've never heard of Alan Wake? Oh my goodness, Starlight, you are in for a treat. I've only been playing this game for about an hour, but I've said it before. This is maybe one of my favorite games. I have a real... Oh, I don't have any more ammo. Okay. This will be the third time I've played this game. I haven't played this the remastered version, but... Oh, hello! And then we got you. Okay. And then we're doing... and then and get your head back up. Cool. But yes, this is the third time I played this game. This is the remastered version. I've never played the remastered version. But Alan Wake is... they don't make enough games like Alan Wake, as far as I'm concerned. And it really... this was... I don't want to say when I fell in love with Remedy games. But this is when I was like, okay, Remedy games, you've really made a very, very, very cool game. Let's see if you can follow this up anyway. And I don't think I'll play it on this channel. Well, maybe I will someday. It'll be the second time I've played it. But then they followed, years later, they followed Alan Wake up with the game Control. Control is so good. Control is also just so good. And I think what I really like about this, I'm gonna say this universe that they've made. You can either call it the Alan Wake universe or the Remedy universe or the Control universe. I don't know. It is very much like a
broken. I had to make my way up some other way.
It is very much like a Stephen King novel where the world is very similar to ours, but there's dark and terrible things in it. And if you're not careful, they'll eat you up.
I couldn't stay here. There had to be a way to get up there.
Examine.
There was no power. There was bound to be a generator somewhere at the logging site.
Well, there's going to be a generator all over the place. That's what, like, this guy. Coffee! Also, I absolutely adore the fact that the collectible in this game is coffee. Because if there's one thing you can get me to go out of my way to collect, it's going to be coffee. Okay. Is there anything else? Any other items? Any other... nope. Hi. How you doing here, sir? Get away. Get away from me, sir. Aha! And then we do this, do this. Oh, wait. And then this. Ow! Shoot. That was close!
With all this forestry equipment around, there had to be something I could use to reach the top.
Well, I mean, I was planning on just turning on the power first. Can I not turn on the power, Mr. Wake? Beep! Gamer, how are you? It was surprised looking up who played Alan the first time I played. I found it was the actor who played Will Scarlet in Robin Hood Men in Tights. Wait. Looking up who played Alan... oh, I see what you mean. I know what that can be like. Hoping you have a great morning. I did not realize that the guy who played Alan Wake first was the guy who played Will Scarlet in Men in Tights. I've never looked that up.
I heard them before I saw them, swooping down from the sky and screeching as they came. I spun around just as the cloud was upon me. For an instant, I stared into 100 dead eyes, black pearls glittering in the darkness.
But enough about Instagram models.
The swarm exploded like fireworks. Feathers burned, turned into ash. I couldn't hear my scream above theirs.
So we are talking about Instagram. All right. And there's gonna be some more bad guys around here. More possessed shadowy Kingdom Hearts people, right? Right?
Beep.
Oh, I'm doing this. That's probably good right about there. Let's see here. There we go. It's noon here, but I don't go to bed until 2 a.m., sometimes 4 a.m., and I'm a light sleeper, so yeah. Oh my goodness. How was your evening and morning, Brock? My evening was fine. I got... Mostly what I did last night was, I'm experimenting with something on YouTube, which was... I normally just post, like, my entire 8-hour streams as one big, long video onto YouTube. But I've recently been, cutting them up into hour-long segments to see if, well, one, it doesn't take, like, an hour and a half to load the video to YouTube. But two, just to see if it's more munchable. It's more fun-packed size for people to watch. If anybody was actually watching my videos, but... So, I did that. I got a little bit of drawing done. Not a lot, but a little bit. Where is it? I'm out of frame. Is it over here? Is this it? Yeah, this is it. Where? Come here. Yeah, right back. There we go. I'm working on my Dead by Daylight loadout. And I'm working on... You know, Ghostface is gonna be the big thing for the next tome. I would like to get these things. I would like to get my Dead by Daylight loadout colored and ready before that actually hits. Well, now that all just fell on the floor. All right, I'll deal with that later. But that's probably what I'm gonna work on the Sunday drawing stream. Of course, having said that, I would be thrilled if Dead by Daylight had its update tomorrow and the new tome was up.
I was just outside for the fresh air, and what a night. I know most of you are probably in your beds by now, but
nope. If
you're still up and around, take a moment. Step outside for a spell and breathe in deep. The weather is absolutely still. The sky is crystal clear. It's like the forest is quietly breathing along with you. You listeners know I'm a night owl, and it's on nights like this I wish I wasn't cooped up in the studio. It makes an old man like me wish I could just roam wild. But here I am, and it would keep you company all night long if I weren't. It looks like I'm not the only one staying up late. Caller, you're on the air.
Uh-huh.
It's Maurice Horton.
Hello, Maurice. What are you up to?
Well, I was just taking Toby on his walk.
Oh, isn't it beautiful out there?
Sure, but Pat, the reason I called is that Toby heard something rustling in the undergrowth and took off after it, and I couldn't find it.
Probably a rabbit.
Sure. Toby loves rabbits.
Okay.
Well, sure.
Anyway, I figured that, you know, if anyone runs into Toby, they could grab him. My number's on his collar.
And Toby's a friendly dog?
Toby loves people.
Loves to bite them.
Well, Maurice, it's out there now. Hope Toby comes home soon.
Yeah, thanks.
You have a good night now.
Well, that must have been very important. Alright, so there's a dog. You need to find a dog. I will burn this entire place to the ground for that dog. Okay, paint? Paint? Is there more paint? Oh, more paint. And then... There it is. Flare. Anything else? No, we're okay. Strange song to be playing in this area. Let's see. Pat Main, the guy on the radio, also played a radio host in GTA 4, Ballad of Gay Tony. Haha! I mean, his character in this is Pat Main. Not sure the actor's name, though. The carnival music is creepy, or it kind of reminded me of carnival music till I heard words. One of the reasons why I really like these games as well is because... Oh, Wake finds pages.
At first,
okay.
I kept finding the pages as if by accident. The book I couldn't remember was either a terrible and true prophecy, or an act of creation that had rewritten the world. I began to hunt the pages feverishly, for they held the answer to the mystery. With it, I could save myself. With it, I could save Alice.
Okay. And can I just... Oh, good. I can just hit start. No, I was gonna say, one of the reasons why these Remedy Alan Wake control games are great...
The gas station is closer now. It's light welcoming in the darkness.
Paul makes the best dogs in the state. Belly Burster is the best with no curves. Monster Dog is second best. The famous dog is...
Yeah, that sounds like Stephen King dialogue. No, I was going to say, they introduced me to the band Poets of the Fall, who they play the old gods of Asgard, I believe, in this game, but they also have some of their music in the video game Control. And they're, not every single one of their songs is a winner, but they're pretty good. I like them a lot. Alright, things are getting foggy. Things are getting weird here. Oh my. Woohoo! Oh dear. Do we this? And whacka whacka! There we are. I want to make sure I get all the items. Are there any items here? Like that. That's a manuscript page. I want that. I want it. Well, maybe I will deal with it in a second. Oh, my word. Oh, my. There's another one. Owie! Jerk. You hit me in the back. Alright, what do we got here? TV in the gas station. Okay.
I stepped into the gas station's garage. It was dark and quiet. The place was a mess. It looked like someone trashed the place or that there'd been some kind of fight. Light spilled into the room through an open door at the back, and I made my way toward it.
Mm-hmm.
Without
mm-hmm.
any warning, I was blinded by a bright light. An old portable TV on the shelf had come alive by itself. Impossibly, I could see myself on the screen, talking like a madman.
But then I remember my old actor days. Or maybe I had a TV interview on Letterman or something, I don't know. Let's see, I never heard of Poets of the Fall before playing this game, but was glad to discover them. Usually it's GTA, Guitar Hero, or Tony Hawk games that introduce me to new bands or songs. Yeah. Well, I've said this before. Really more about the internet in general, which is whenever anything gets like super popular or like the brand new hotness or whatever in the world, the internet is a really, really big... Dang it. Leave me alone. Thank you. The internet is a very, very big place, and it's hard to keep track of all the new whatever that's going on in the world. So, yeah, how are we supposed to... I am not doing well. Yeah, how are we supposed to keep track of everything that is coming out every single day? Like, good luck keeping up with, you know, like, whatever is just the funny new saying or whatever that's on Twitter or Instagram. I mean, it took me a while to learn who, what is it, BTS? I think that's their name. The South Korean band. See, I still don't even really know who they are. The ones that just, broke up. And then everybody went, oh no! I never thought the band would break up! There's no historical context for this! I am not doing well. Safe here? Well, I hope that's true. There we are. Okay. Well, got myself a little breather. Is Jeepers Creepers Reborn any good? I've heard it's terrible. Starlight, I've heard it's absolutely terrible. It's ever-changing in some things you discover, and then old new days later. They did break up technically, but they're getting ready to do that mandatory military unless rules change. You know what? At the same time, though, I hope they do have to do the mandatory military thing. Something that has been pointed out recently by a lot of people is the fact that, you know, I remember hearing stories about, you know, actors from the 30s and the 40s who went and served in World War II, and then they came back after the fact and, you know, continued their acting career. Or you would hear stories like Clint Eastwood, for that matter. Clint Eastwood was in the military, and was he in World War II? I think he was in World War II when he was a teenager. And I think that's one of the reasons why Clint Eastwood is such the hard case that he is. Because he's seen some stuff. And it's one of the reasons why Clint Eastwood makes really good movies. Because Clint Eastwood has lived. He has been through some stuff. He has seen some stuff. And that translates into his movies. Somebody has pointed this out because they were trying to figure out, well, why does Amazon's The Rings of Power suck so much? Why does She-Hulk suck so much? And they've basically figured out that, like, well, it's because a lot of the people who are writing are modern-day movies, comics, TV shows, and stuff like that. They've never actually gone and lived. They've never actually gone out and done anything on their own. All they've ever done is read about adventure in the world and war and things like that. And oh my goodness, I've got a sneeze coming. I can feel it. I'm gonna get here into the light, because oh my word. But basically, one of the big problems that we have with people who are writing our entertainment is that all they've ever done is read about people going on adventures. They've never actually gone on an adventure themselves. So this is a long and drawn out way of saying BTS, I'm not saying like these kids need to go out and go to have war, but they do need to leave this, let's face it, famous sheltered life that they're currently living, because that is going to only make their art better. Because they will understand, or have a better understanding of suffering and trials and tribulations and things like that. It will make them appreciate their fans a little bit more. It'll make them understand their fans a little bit more. I think it would be a very, very healthy thing. And honestly, I'm not someone who's going to say that, like, mandatory military mandatory rules and regulations are something that I even want here in America. But it might not be a bad thing. Or at least kids, like, mandatory ROTC in school. Because let's face it, a lot of kids are a bunch of spoiled little, rotten little, no good so-and-sos. They need to get their teeth kicked in with the real world. I always think back to, I mean, if we're not going to force kids into ROTC or the military, everybody should have a mandatory Scared Straight program. You guys remember those? I don't remember what TV show they were or what talk show they were, but they're like, my troubled child is out of control, and they cut over to some overweight 80-pound 6-year-old just knocking everything down, going to a store and ripping clothes apart, and like, I don't know what to do. What am I can't hit him with the back of my hand and build character like that, because that's just not socially acceptable anymore. What am I to do, Maury? Jerry Springer? And this is exactly how they talk also, by the way. So they're like, all right, we're going to do the only sensible thing. We can't hit your child, so we're just going to send him to prison. I think hitting the child would have been a much easier thing to do, but, you know, whatever. I'm not a parent. Not my place to say. But, so they send these kids to prison. And they're like, all right, you're going to live with the inmates for a couple of days. Hi. Hey, 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 there's nothing wrong with salad, except the fact that it's cold. Warm the salad up. Put it all in a soup. Then I'll scrunch it all up. Seriously, I don't eat salad either. But you put everything that's in a salad into a soup? Oh, yum, 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 yum. Delicious. Just don't like it. I don't like cold. I don't like the cold. Oh, great. That's wonderful. Leave me alone. Go in here. Ooh, shotgun ammo. Why, yes, I will. And doing this. And... TV? What's on the TV? Night Springs!
It bestows immortality on those who advance it to elevate...
They didn't break up. Sometimes that can hurt them and change the style that... style they make music. I think they could make a comeback after the 2 years if they want to. There are idols who made comebacks after the mandatory 2 years. Oh gosh, I hated ROTC, but I took it preferred over PE. Quantum suicide. Hey, Renixie!
It would take a courageous man to change the script. Having called a press conference, Dr. Barclay Colvin is about to demonstrate that very courage.
Ladies and gentlemen of the press, I am Dr. Barclay Colvin, and I'm glad so many of you could join me here.
I love these little things.
Tonight, I'm going to give a practical demonstration of the many worlds interpretation. As you can see, this is a loaded 9mm pistol. It shall be part of a thought experiment. And now, a real experiment, known as a quantum suicide.
Did he say suicide? Is that a real gun? He's kidding, right?
He just said
please,
it was.
Please, stay calm. There is no risk. Observe what occurs when I place the weapon against my own forehead. Now, you might think this round is merely a dud. Not so. Observe the flower pot. And yet... I myself cannot be harmed with this gun. With each pull of the trigger, two new realities branch off. One in which the weapon didn't fire, and one where it did. With my machine here, I have ensured that this reality is always the former. I have bestowed upon myself quantum immortality. Under no circumstances can this gun kill me.
So wait. What you're saying is that every time you pull the trigger, in another reality, you die?
Yes, of course, but that's completely trivial. There's an infinite number of things that could happen at any moment, and they always do happen somewhere. The point is, this one thing did not happen here.
You're insane, Colvin.
Insane? Insane?
In the membrane!
Hey. Supposed to be plugged in? I stumbled on it.
You fools! Gaze upon quantum immortality!
Oh my goodness! Quantum immortality looks like raspberry jam out of your brain!
Dr. Colvin, filled by his own hubris or the ignorance of the masses. Perhaps he should have left the crate unopened, the decaying atom unobserved. Curiosity often kills the cat. Night Springs.
Hey, leave the cat alone, Night Springs. Cat killers. Monsters. What's this? Alan Wake. I haven't played this in a while. Love Alan Wake from Nixie. Love it. I love this Night Springs episode. That's one way to put it. Beetlejuice waking up, have a few things to clean, but good. Alright. Are they still out here? I'm just gonna go for the manuscript page, and then I'm gonna go back inside. Yeah. Well, Archer, Wake lies to the sheriff.
The cabin on Cauldron Lake? She asked. The sheriff looked at me suspiciously. The early morning light flooded through the office windows. I would probably never have gotten out of the woods alive without her help. But I couldn't tell her the truth of what I'd faced the previous night. She'd think I was lying, or crazy. She'd lock me up, and she wouldn't help me find Alice.
Yeah, well, I mean, I think that's perfectly reasonable. All right, so there's one page that I haven't found that I can't get in not nightmare mode. Lame. I mean, there's a part of me that almost wants to start the game over again in nightmare mode, but no, not doing that. It's locked. What, is there a monster? What's, things are getting spooky. Are things spooky? What's happening? There's a lot of there's so many farts. So many farts in the air. Is there a, what am I doing here? What's happening? Where? Is there, are there like lights I can turn on? Everything. What am I doing here? Are there terrible things? I think there might be terrible things. What's happening? I don't need any lithium batteries. I don't need any revolver ammo. Okay. Hello? Are there any? There we are.
It's me. It's Stucky.
Okay, I am good. Is there a place where I can? Okay, so there's coffee. Dang it! Ow! They're pushing me, mommy. Oh, I was hoping there was a, like a spotlight or something I could turn on. How about you? Wait, is that an exploding barrel? Is that an exploding barrel? Nope, it's not. It's not. In fact, it. I thought it was red. I thought it might be exploding, but it's not. Very disappointed. Shotgun shell? No. Yeah, wait. We're stuck here. There he is! Stucky, come back, Stucky. I have to hit you with my shotgun. I keep on trying to sprint with the L3 stick, and that doesn't work in this game. Oh my word. Where are you? Where are you? There you are! Ah! Yeah! Eat this. Eat this. Continue to eat. Oh, only two shots. Eat this. Yay!
Stucky's body vanished, leaving behind only a lifetime of nightmares to come. Assuming I'd reach the lights at the gas station alive.
Okay. And really? A lifetime of nightmares? I don't know about that. Alright, is there a manuscript page around here? It's a big open area. Let's see here. Earlier this year, it was announced that AMC is doing an Alan Wake series. Not sure what it will be like, but it would be cool to see an episode that was just a nice Springs episode. All I hear is the noise the fog is making. I really hope that Alan Wake series is good. I think it depends on who's behind it. Like, what kind of a talent do they have? And obviously, are the people who are behind the series, are they fans of Alan Wake? Because this would be my dream. This would be what I would really hope. Once more, one of the reasons why I like Alan Wake even more now is because of Control, the video game that Remedy put out, I want to say about 2 years ago. And Control is like, they don't have the rights to the CCP investigation or organization, that online Reddit whatever series, or just a bunch of short stories. So they kind of made their own version of it. And Alan Wake is in that game. He's part of the DLC. Or I should say, there's Alan Wake DLC for that game. So I would love it if Alan Wake was just the first series. Or the first TV series. All in the same universe. And it could be like a new version of the X-Files. I don't know. I don't know if they're gonna do that, but I would really hope that whoever's making the Alan Wake TV series acknowledges the Control Bureau existing within the Alan Wake series. Where am I supposed to go? Reach the gas station. Yeah. So there's this button here. That's a loud hum. Is that your computer or the game console? Oh, yeah, I don't know what's going on here. What is that? That's coming from my microphone. Alright, hold on a second. We're going to... properties. Let's do this. We're gonna... device... Can I deactivate this? I'm gonna try and deactivate this real quick. Do this. I'm working on it. Why in the world? What in the world? Alright, I'm turning this down. Okay, how about that? Is that better? How is that? Are we... Okay, so it looks like... Better? Okay. Yeah, I didn't notice what that was. Sometimes it is the PlayStation 5, but no, you were not wrong. There was a... Like, looking at the meter, there was a loud hum or something. I think I just had to play with the settings on the microphone. I don't know what that was. Anyway. Ugh. Okay. What was I doing? There we are. Okay. Still looking for that final manuscript page. I need you. It's good that you people are watching, because I need you to tell me when my audio goes crazy, because I don't hear it. It's just like, I wish somebody told me.
I recognized the parade float I had seen in Bright Falls when I first arrived with Alice.
Help me, Alan. My life is an existence of torture. Help me. No, I was going to say, I wish somebody had told me that sooner. How badly my audio was out of sync when I had played PlayStation 5 games before. Because, like, right now I'm going through and editing my Demon's Souls playthrough, and there's like a half second delay on the audio on the PlayStation, not on the stream, because my lips.
The insanity I just experienced in the darkness, the lights of the gas station felt comforting. At least for a moment, the sane world reasserted itself.
Okay. Yeah, the. My audio and my talkie-talkie-talk on my face lines up, syncs up just fine, but the game audio is out of sync. And I didn't realize. I didn't know. I guess it was just a problem with the audio capture on the PlayStation 5. But nobody had really pointed it out until I was playing Returnal. Last one. Okay.
He spat on the garage floor and tried to shake the cobwebs from his head. Ever since the couple never showed to pick up the keys, things had been fuzzy. Something, a feeling, caught his attention. Stucky looked up and stared as his brain tried in vain to process the horror before him. He stumbled back, knocking over a can of oil. A black pool spread across the floor while he struggled for a brief moment, then let go as the unrelenting darkness engulfed him.
That sounds terrible. I watched somebody play Hellblade yesterday. It's a strange game. The consistent whispers are fun. Hellblade is a game that I want to
the
play.
The Deerfest had been 2 weeks away when we arrived. If the day count on the banner was right, I was missing a whole week between the night we got here and now.
It's been 1 week since I arrived in Bright Falls. Cocked my head to the side and fell off a cliff. Now I'm got to come up with lyrics, trying to come up with something clever to say, but I'm trying to stay in the
garage was a mess. It looked like someone had trashed the place, or that there'd been some kind of fight.
If you think this is a trash, you haven't been to my house. Please do not recycle. Please do not recycle. That's right, forget the planet. What has the planet ever done for us, except try to kill us? That's what natural disasters are.
All right, I'll keep writing. Outside, there's only darkness. Outside the cabin, outside the story, there's only darkness. I can feel her presence in the dark. Just now, I could smell her perfume in the room. I'll reach her, I'll fix it up. I'll bring her back. The story will come true. If I stop, she's lost.
I don't believe this. It'd been me on the TV, talking crazy. Was I losing my mind?
Well, I mean, no, you've been on TV before. Nordic Walling, incontestably proven health benefits. Isn't that just walking with a cane? Is that what? Welcome! Oh, thank you for having me. Special offer with coupon. Wiper Pro, socket wrench set, windshield clean, anti-rust. Ooh, I would like some anti-rust. Bright Halls Hunting Club. And what are these? These are yummies. Gummy yummies. I want some gummy yummies. Can I have gummy yummies? Vacation CR cabin rental options. Peaceful locations. Beautiful scenery. Modern facilities. Habitable all year round. And it doesn't look like any of those are the cabin that I went to. We sell propane. New customer special. Is there anything like special in here? Should I even be in here? What is this? LOL, this monologue. Is he writing a book? Oh no, Starlight. He is. Well, that's one of the mysteries about Alan Wake. So basically the story so far in the game, Starlight, is this is Alan Wake. Hello, I'm Alan Wake. And he is a writer, but he's had writer's block for like the last 2 years. So he and his wife have come to this town, Bright Falls, basically for some R&R. But his wife also had another reason to bring him here, because she thought, like, hey, maybe this is a place where you can relax and actually get some writing done. In fact, there's even a doctor here who specializes in this type of thing. So he stormed off in a huff. He's like, oh, I can't believe you want, you just want me to write. But then his wife disappeared. He runs back into the house, and then he wakes up. It's been a week. He doesn't remember the last week. His wife is still missing. There's all these shadowy creatures appearing all over the place, and he's finding manuscript pages lying all about the place. And it's his writing, and it's a book that he was planning to write, but he doesn't remember writing any of this stuff. And on top of that, everything that he finds in the manuscript, everything that he wrote is coming true. So that's the mystery of Alan Wake.
I had to get inside the gas station to find a phone to call for help.
Well, oh, so I was supposed to go for the phone? Oh, okay. So since it is, since he is an author, this game really plays up the self-narration that's going on. This must be that phone I was looking for.
Bright Falls Sheriff Station.
Hi, I know that you heard a man's voice answer the call.
Thank God, Sheriff.
Sheriff Sarah Breaker, you are...
I'm Alan Wake, but listen, I was in a car crash. My wife, Alice, she's missing.
Calm down, Mr. Wake.
We were staying in a cabin on the island, on Cauldron Lake.
There's no island on Cauldron Lake, not since the big eruption in the 70s.
Please, I can take you there, okay?
You look like you've taken a pretty bad knock to the head. Are you okay?
No, you just mentioned I took a giant knock to the head.
Out. Please get in the car. We'll swing by the lake and then we'll go to the station, okay? Mr. Wake, have you seen Stucky, the guy who owns this place?
I realized I couldn't tell her what had happened in the forest. She wouldn't have believed me. And then she wouldn't have helped me with Alice.
I pretended I was a bird and flew far, far, far away. We dramatically looked at each other with close-up shots, cutting from one person to the next. Then I pretended I was a bird again and flew far, far, far away. And then we cut to a commercial. They call the Sandman. Tiptoes to my room every night. Just a sprinkle of stardust and a whisper. Another interesting thing about this game is the fact that when it was, there's been some documentaries about it. They're gonna wake.
I came to Bright Falls with my wife, Alice.
Here you go.
Thank you for coming here with me. I thought maybe you could write here.
I don't want to hear it. God damn it, Alice.
Now, she's missing.
Alice? Alice?
I woke up behind the wheel of a crashed car. I'm missing a week. I was attacked by shadowy men straight from a nightmare. The sheriff took me to the lake Alice and I had stayed at. But the cabin had disappeared.
Sure did. Oh, great. I'm forgetting the actor's name. Dagnabbit. Qui-Gon Jinn. Why do I keep on wanting to say Sam Neill? It's not Sam Neill. Dang it. I've completely forgotten the actor's name. Dang it!
Honey, I'm home.
Okay.
Back here, sweetie. How was it?
Worst weather I've ever seen.
You should put some coffee on. It'll warm you up.
That sounds amazing. All right, I was going to say, there have been documentaries, YouTube documentaries written about or produced about the making of this game. About how when this game was first in development, they were going to make it like an episodic and just release the episodes individually. But Microsoft, who was going to publish the game, said, no, don't do that. That's not going to work out. That no game will sell like that. Just sell the whole thing as one single piece. But they had already kind of split up the story to be episodic. So you're going to see episode 1, episode 2, episode 3 appear in this game. Except when the game came out, it just all came out together. But they just kept it in because they're like, listen, we've already cut it up into chapters. Let's just leave the episodes in. Now, what's interesting is years later, games like Telltale's The Walking Dead and Tales of the Borderlands and things like that came out that did the whole releasing games episodically. And it was massively successful. But Alan Wake was going to be the first one to try that out. But Microsoft is the one that held them back and said, don't do that. The Shining Hotel is somewhere around these woods. A whole show about the history of Bright Falls over the centuries would even be possible, let alone what happens in the time. Liam Neeson, there you are. I hate when that happens too. And what's terrible is, like, I know Liam Neeson. I have heard of Liam Neeson. I am very familiar with Liam Neeson.
Coffee's on.
Well, I mean, it started.
I'll need it if I'm gonna finish this by tomorrow.
So, somebody want to explain to me what the benefit or what's so nice about living in New York is? Because, seriously, this weather. This is New York. I just went through a hurricane here in Florida, and I still would prefer that than this nonsense in New York City. That looks absolutely terrible. Shut up, New York! I don't care about what you have to say about this situation. I know that you're listening in. I know that you're calling to give me a hard time, but I don't care. Look at that. It's awful. It's just totally awful. Disgusting. Look at you, put your pictures up of what pristine New York looked like. No, I don't believe it. These are lies. These are lies. It's covered with snow and awfulness. That's what it is. And more pictures of New York trying to entice me to go to New York. No, no, you won't fool me. No, look at it. Look at all those people. Just clumped up, stacked on top of each other. Yuck, icky, icky, icky. Oh, hi, Krazy. How are you doing? I was just talking about how terrible New York is. Ooh, manuscript. The sudden... Oh, there's two, actually.
It's true what they say about the fall and the sudden stop at the end. I'd lain here in the snow while the lurid chain of scenes that had led me here kept playing in my head. A rerun of my own private snuff movie. A memory of my corpse. Alone at my own wake. Thinking and bored again. The femme fatale was gone. Only a sour taste remained of the kiss that killed me.
Don't you mean you were alone at my own Alan Wake? Gotta keep on brand here.
This was a late goodbye. 13 years after I'd gotten my revenge, it had finally caught up with me. It had been a long time to bear the pain. My blood painted the snow red, a gruesome slushy, dissolved all the scattered painkillers and leisurely dripped down to the sewer, mingling with the bile of the city, becoming one with it. I can see them now, my wife and my baby. Honey, I'm home.
Now, you might disparage it, but I'm telling you right now, if 7-Eleven introduced the painkiller slushy, hotcakes. Sell like hotcakes. I personally would totally go into a 7-Eleven and pick up the painkiller slushy. That sounds amazing. I hate when I have this. Shame, Microsoft. I like how they place the FBC building in control in New York. Hi, Krazy. It is terrible. Hi, Star. It's cool that VA from Max Payne, James McAvoy voices Alex Casey in these two manuscripts. Well, I mean, obviously, Remedy has a working relationship with him. And he's happy for the work. Because I don't know how successful of an actor he is. I mean, he's successful, but no, he's not turning down work. Let me put it that way. He's not turning down any roles because he's got just so much going on. Alan Wake. The Fall of Casey, Things That Want, Alex Casey, What I Can't Forget, Return to Sender, an Alex Casey thriller, blah, 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 blah. Okay, and then Double Guns. Okay. Is that like a Max Payne reference? Oh, wait, did I just see Max Payne on the shelf? I could have sworn in the corner of my eye, I saw something. Did I? No, I'm just seeing things. For a second, I thought I saw a book that said Max Payne on the shelf. But I was wrong. Look at all this. I mean, again. This is New York. Ew. Ew.
The continuing freezing rain and heavy snowfall have necessitated a winter storm warning in the entire tri-state area. People are advised to stay indoors as many roadways are already closed, and city officials are not expecting snow crews to keep up with the weather. We're now on the third day of the blizzard, and the weather is not expected to clear up anytime soon.
Yep. Sounds terrible. Enjoy the weather up above the Mason-Dixon line, people, because ew. I will say they have a wonderful shower. That's a very nice shower. That cough just won't break and go away, will it? Well, Starlight, I actually was just talking to somebody in my family about this. Which was, so once upon a time when I was still working at Disney, long story short, in my car I had an accident, back right of my car got totally smashed, I got it repaired at the body shop, but what I didn't know, and what they didn't know, was when they fixed it, the glue that they used to kind of put some of the pieces back together, it didn't water seal it properly. So every time it rained, water was actually going into my car. Like, somewhere inside of my car. Not like in the trunk or in the backseat or anything like that. Just somewhere underneath it. So I couldn't see. And there's a very real possibility. Mold had started to grow in my car. But I didn't know. Because I couldn't see it anywhere. It was somewhere inside of the car. So I was driving around in this mold-filled car for maybe a year. Or at least several months. So there's no way for me to really know or prove it. But I'm fairly certain just breathing that in for over like a year. Because again, it was while I was working at Disney. And I had an hour commute to and from Disney every day. So breathing in that moldy air for at least 2 hours every single day. it probably had a lasting effect on me. So when I get sick with a cough, it takes a long time to get rid of it. Sometimes a month or two. I feel fine, but it's going to take forever. It's going to take forever for me to get rid of this cough. It sucks. Sucks. But I do enjoy a cough drop. Let's see. Unfortunately, they couldn't directly put Max Payne into the game because by that point, Rockstar put the IP, but Alex Casey was their way of referencing Mac. Yeah. All right, honey. Oh, hey. I've gone through our house.
Those cover mock-ups? They're on your desk. Tell me what you think.
Oh, I was
no
just...
kidding. I didn't think you'd get them done this quickly.
On occasion, I can perform all sorts of miracles, my dear.
Oh, really?
Well, you seem to think so last night.
Whoa! That got spicy. Hey, I was just in here. Should I take out my cell phone and try and... Can I take my cell phone out and scan that QR code? Alan Wake, why do you have a QR code on your wall? What is this?
These look really good.
Except for that ugly guy on them.
Barry gets his hands on them, which, by the way, will happen over my dead body. The last time was the last time.
Oh, and speaking of Barry, he called. Alan?
I'm right here.
Please check the fuse box.
I'm right here. I'm on it, honey.
Please hurry.
I'm
right here, baby.
I'm going.
I'm fine. Just get the lights back on. Now,
honey,
please.
It's a power outage. I've got the flashlight.
Okay. Hi.
Hi.
Okay.
I'm sorry. It just really spooked me.
Don't worry. We'll just break out the candles.
I know it's stupid, but it's just... especially when I'm not prepared for it, you know? It gets to me.
I love you.
That's a weird thing to say.
Writer.
Okay.
But I mean, after she was talking about that, I mean...
I used to have these nightmares when I was a kid. The dark really spooked me, too. When it got really bad, my mom gave me this old light switch. She called it the clicker.
The clicker, huh?
Yeah. If I ever got scared of the dark, I could just flip the switch and a magic light would scare the monsters away.
I was a stupid kid.
Here it is.
Alan.
Maybe it'll help you, too.
Yeah.
Wait, you still... what, you had it? You had it, like, in your pants?
No, didn't you?
No, no. Seriously.
I love you, even if you are a liar. Thanks for this.
By the way, now that we've talked about how I am a liar, I would like to once again reaffirm that I have never had an affair. Never had an affair. Oh, well, all those people have power.
How do you feel, Mr. Wick? Any nausea, disorientation, anything like that?
Well, I do have this bright light in my eye.
How are you feeling?
I'm okay. My head's fine. I had to lie about my headache and memory loss. He'd send me to a hospital for tests. I couldn't leave without Alice.
Very well. I don't think you have a concussion, but you've obviously been through quite a shock.
And somebody's hitting you with the ugly stick.
Thanks.
end, Mr. Wake, we're done here. If the pain gets any worse or you experience any other symptoms, you should come see me.
Hi, I'm Tall.
Done with it then. Sarah, Sheriff Breaker, is waiting for you. She's very good at her job. I'm sure she can locate your wife in no time.
You do what I command.
The image of a small town doctor. Sheriff Breaker had called him to the station to take a look at the cut in my head.
Yes, obviously. Do as I command. I am king here. Now I am the tallest. Do not pay attention to the fact that I am standing on top of this chair with only a single foot, and my other foot is just hanging out into the emptiness. No, pay attention to that. I am just using my very heel, my heel, to stand on this chair.
Just go down the corridor.
I have a very, very powerful, strong heel. Look at that. Look at that. Perfect posture. Completely standing upright. I'm not even having a hard time keeping my balance. Such is the power of my single heel on my right foot.
You're good to go, Mr. Wake. Sarah's probably waiting for a chance to talk to you.
But what does that have to do with about the strength that's in my right heel?